No, it's been 3 weeks since a Seoul ferry capsized off the southwestern coast of Korea. 269 people are confirmed dead and 35 are still missing. Initially, that number of the missing was 33, but authorities say there was a mistake made during the confirmation process.
Right, the number of passengers on board remains unchanged still at 476 for now. For more, we connect live to our Kim Ji-yeon at the news center. Now, while the search for the missing continues, the investigations as to why and how the ferry sank are proceeding at a fast pace. What's the latest there, Ji-yeon?
Well, guys, an official of the Korea Shipping Association, which oversees the shipping industry, was arrested today over suspicions of taking bribes from ferry operators like the Cheonghaejin Marine Company in exchange for overlooking insurance fraud. The nonprofit organization is in charge of inspecting and certifying vessels on behalf of the government, and prosecutors are looking for any evidence of wrongdoing in relation to the safety inspection of the Seoul ferry and whether KSA officials were bribed in exchange for lax inspection.
Right, Ji-yeon. So authorities are proceeding their investigation, presuming that the ferry operator had knowledge that there were potential problems with this vessel.
Well, Konyoung, that may be the case. Prosecutors found that the ferry operator tried to sell the Seoul ferry online in March at a price around $16 million. At least one buyer from the Philippines wished to buy the ferry. And during the sale, the ferry operator did not reveal to its broker that it may be unstable and could quickly recover its balance since it was renovated so that more space would be available for cargo and passengers. Prosecutors are trying to prove that the ferry operator knew of the faults beforehand and wanted to sell it off.
And Jim, where do things stand with regard to the investigations into business irregularities of Yoo Byung-eun, no longer the mysterious millionaire, now known as the de facto owner of the ferry operator?
Well, Daniel, prosecutors are casting a wide net here. They are looking into Byung Gi-chun, the president of I1I Holdings, as well as Haemo Group president Ko Chang-hwan. I1I Holdings owns a large stake in Cheonhaeji, a shipbuilding unit that holds the largest stake of the ferry operator. Ko had been the president of I1I Holdings for nearly 2 years, from 2008 to the year 2010. And the two are suspected of providing slush funds to Yoo Byung-eun, the de facto owner of the ferry operator, worth tens of millions of dollars.
Ji-yeon, let's shift our focus to the search operations. We all know that these are quite dangerous work for all of those involved. And it's only been underscored by the death of a very experienced diver yesterday. Now, what is being done to ensure the safety of the rescue divers today?
Well, Konyoung, more medical staff have been deployed right now at the accident site. And up until now, there was only one emergency technician on the boat that served as a station for the divers before they went into the water. Additional medical staff were some 900 meters away from the ferry site, but there was criticism that transporting an injured diver to that location would be a waste of precious time. And the change comes after that civilian diver died while searching for the bodies that remain unaccounted for. And at least 116 divers were on standby to help the search of the Seoul ferry on Wednesday. I'll be back with more updates in later newscasts.